You've got to dedicate every day. It ain't a sport that you can just stop and pick it up again. You got to do sit-ups. You got to do push-ups. You got to hit the speed bag. You got to hit the heavy bag. Shadow box. You got to spar. You start adding up all these things. It's a grueling workout. If they want it, they stay. If they don't want it, they leave. It takes a big heart. You know, and it takes a kid that wants to dedicate, you know. Anybody can come in and work out, but that don't mean they're going to be a boxer. You know, like, they don't fight. They just want to work out because of the gruelingness of it. They don't all have to fight, you know. That ain't what the gym's about. The gym's about saving youth, you know.
Oh,
so you don't hurt your wrist. That's why you
look at the skin. It's twisted.
Twisted.
Right here.
There you go.
Right
in the hook. Right? Screw up.
Nice. Hands up. Don't drop them down, Josh. When you're stepping up, keep them up in your jaw.
Ready? Ready? So exhausted, there's nothing to think about. You're gonna have muscles hurting that you didn't know you had muscles there. But once you come into the gym here and you work out for, I would say, 6 weeks, everything, their blood pressure goes down, everything works for them, they start eating correctly, they're not eating the junk at night, and they enjoy that, you know. You know, the mental part is you're taking that stress away because, you know, you're hitting the bag. You're hitting the speed bag, you're jumping rope, you know, I mean, it takes your mind off a lot of things, you know.
I think it motivation and also gives them some discipline and also makes them a better person, a leader in the community. That's what we want. You know, we don't want the kids out there causing trouble. We want to try to say, hey, look at this, you know, there's good people out there and, you know, you should take advantage of it.
It's a great opportunity to get better and better.
Kick some butt.
Getting hit in the face and stuff.
Knocking somebody out.
Yeah. Once you have a fight, your hand's counted as illegal. So you just have to use your words to back people down.
We're not actually going to go around school and knocking people out. Pop, 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 pop.
Yeah. Can't be like George, you're picking fights with kids.
Hey, so. Shut up. I don't pick fights.
I want the parents to be aboard because that can be a distraction to the kid if they're not aboard. My big thing is them not getting hurt. So when they walk through the door here, I want to make sure both parents are on an agreement that, you know, 5 months down the road after I worked hard with this kid, oh, I don't want my son boxing now because I think he's going to get hurt, you know. And I want them to have trust in me that I will take care of their child, you know. But I tell them when they walk through this door, their kid is mine for that 2 hours. I don't want no distractions or I don't want them in here because I want the kid to know what he has to do to protect himself and do things. I just want the kid's attention so we can make a nice gentleman in the end of this too, you know?
In this gym, we don't let anybody, if they get too aggressive and too overwhelming, we stop it. We don't let that happen because that's not what we're here for. We don't want the kids to get hurt. We want them, you know, to know how to fight, know how to box, and, you know the strategy and the technique and all that.
Distraction! Come on!
That's right, let's go.
6. 8. Yeah. I should be faster. Come on. 10. 2, 3. 1, 2. Don't think. 2, 3. 1, 2. Double jab right. Double jab right. Double jab right.
So simple to teach a young kid. than it is to teach a grown-up. And people look at me like, what do you mean by that? And I say, because the kids get it more, you know? They're fearless, though. We're grown-ups saying, hey, if I get hit, this is going to hurt, right?
I want your hands up at all times. Not in there to kill each other. You're in there to learn off of each other. So that way, when you fight someone, you'll be all set. You got sparring partners. You learn how to work together.
Sparring's for learning. This is where you find out if they got the heart or not to stay in the gym. Some of them stay, some of them go.
But you're there to work. I'm going to tell you to break and break. I want your hands up at all times. I want both of you sitting down with your hands up and just tapping each other, okay? Don't do it, ha, 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 like to kill each other. I'm telling you right now. But then I'm going to put the gloves on and knock both of you out.
Oh, no. To be honest, this is my first spar.
Yeah. So, you a little nervous?
Not really. I mean, I already know how he fights, so.
Ready? Ready?
You're doing good, yeah?
Set, go.
Touch hands. Tap, tap. I don't want you guys killing each other. You can throw, but not to kill. Move your head side to side. Hands up at all times. I don't want no uppercuts. You don't even know how to throw straight punches. There you go. Don't turn your head. Look at him. Can you see without your glasses?
Yeah.
Don't look at me. Just pay attention when I... Wide open. Don't get careless.
Yeah, it's very hard to take it personal. A lot of kids in here get a little upset. No one wants to be the guy to get beat in front of everybody or gets like told a little more because one guy's gonna do better than the other guy.
I gotta admit, yeah, you sometimes get mad when they go a little bit overboard and get you with that couple of hooks and body shots. At the end of the day, it's a workout. It's boxing. That's what it is.
It's helpful, you get work done, you work on a couple things, you find out what you need to improve on. You know, the opposite to boxing is to hit and not get hit, and that's one of the things Ray repeats to everybody, especially me, because I don't move well, because I'm the whitest guy in here.
A little bit of blood. Keep them hands up. Where's the water?
It's like most matches that people get angry when they lose, but here, we train to get better, not to hate each other. We're brothers here. The more we fight, the more we get better. Become better friends and brothers.
The object of the game is to teach them not to get hit back, right? So you teach them how to box, how to come in, how to come out. You know what I mean? It's the same in every gym.
Come on, come on. Pick it up loud and clear. Come on. What are you doing? Ballet?
97. 93. 94. 95. 96. 97. 98. 99. 100.
Up. Whoever don't do it right is going to owe me 5 more. Down.
Three.
Up. Down.
Four.
You need your knees down.
Five.
Up. Come on, move those legs, baby. Down.
Six.
Come on. Down. Up.
Nine.
Down. Up.
Six.
One more. Down. Up. Pay attention right now. Look at me when I'm talking. Hey, look here. Hey, everybody, look here. You got to stop on the edges right here. I'll say stop, you got to stop. Big man! Breathe! You got him, baby, you got him! Get ready to pass it! Hey, back of the line, Andrew! Give it to him, go! Hey, he dropped it! Hey, back, Andrew! Better hurry up and get it! Too bad!
That's not right!
Yeah, it is right, you're supposed to grab it! Oh, that ain't retarded! Oh, for you, everything's retarded because it don't go your way?
Yeah, when he gets back to school.
You don't need the best, yeah. You need a pair of boxing gloves, a jump rope, some heavy bags. I mean, I'm more of the old school style. New stuff doesn't make a kid a better fighter or make a fighter. A fighter makes his own, you know what I mean? So whether it's new or old, still the same in the boxing world.
I don't care what the place looks like. I mean, if you have a new gym, that's great, but you want the people that are running that gym know what they're doing. And without that, you can have all the fancy things you want. A place like this does it for me. And a lot of kids, they don't even blink. They just come in.
As far as fighters go, Johnny Roach, I think, is making a comeback. He was a hell of a fighter a couple years ago. He's making a comeback. He's only 26, and I think he's going to be a force to be reckoned with in the heavyweight division. Eddie, he could do all right because he's a tough kid. Doesn't like to listen, but doesn't like to give up either. Andrew is probably our youngest kid that might end up being one of our best fighters, but he's 11 years old, so hope we keep him on the right path and keep him in the gym. Pedro's brand new, he's got no fights, but he's a physical specimen that if we can mix that the physical with the boxing, he could be something to talk about.
I'm hoping to become a professional fighter out of this. I just try to rush this train as much as possible. I know you shouldn't be rushing anything, and everything takes time to perfect. But I'm 23 now, and I just don't see a lot of time just hanging around, so I really want to get to the show on the road and start boxing as soon as possible in tournaments and fights and get my name and publicize as much as possible.
I want to make a living out of this. My plan is probably to try to make a living out of this for a little while, probably like a year or so. If that doesn't work out, then explore military or college or more traditional routes. Yeah, I'd like to be a world champ.
We've had over 300 kids in here in 3 years. And a lot of them do quit because it's hard. You know, I don't call them quitters or anything. They, you know, they'll be back. They do come back eventually, you know.
If you don't finish high school, you're going to make $6 an hour, right? Now, if you go to college and get an education, you could make $200,000 a year. So what are you going to do? Just finish high school, or do you want to make $200,000 a year? All right. So that means you got to go an extra 5 years. You can't even make it a year in a gym. How the hell are you going to go 5 more years of school? Huh? How? Oh, I don't know. That's not good to your age. Listen, this is building character, okay? And that means you were here every single day when you fought, right? You did a good job, right? Now, hey, some guys win their first 5 fights, some guys don't. But that doesn't mean because you lost one fight that you're not a good fighter. You gotta get this. You know, we're not always, you know what? It takes a long time to get at the top.
We're not going Chad, they ask him why.
Come on, tell them.
Quit.
Quit. You don't want to box no more? Why?
Everybody's going to give you a, he's a boss at work. Ask him what he does with his guys. What happens when they don't come in?
You gotta get back to
them! Come here, work out. Don't get disappointed. Don't think we don't want you here. We want all you guys here. You want to go back to it eventually, then you go back to it. But you gotta still come in here and work out and stuff. With the guys, but, you know, maybe spot a little bit, maybe, you know.
Keep it up, you know what I mean?
It's up to you. Confidence back and then you want to fight again.
We're gonna be doing that intense training, just doing some of the
oh, you are?
He wanted to quit. Because he lost his first fight and he doesn't want to rematch that kid. That's why.
The kid, he's gonna get it. You know, and that's what's important with me. In any sport I've ever coached, it's not about how great they are. Because once you do that, you lose them. You want them to work even harder for the next fight, you know what I mean? Because every fight that they win, they're going to fight a better fighter. So what you're trying to teach them is to get better.
See, when you start, like when the bell rings, right? You look at the bag like someone that's your opponent. You stand there, bang, 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 bang. See it? Then you move. Boom.
Bitch, 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 b
Nice and straight.
Don't overthink it, man. This is what you want to go out and do?
Bang, bang, bang.
Just do that.
They get the jitters. Everybody should, though. If you don't, it's not normal not to. Oh, yeah, you get jittery. They get nervous. You have to have some kind of, you just can't say, I'm calm. There is no fighter out there that just goes in there calm. You got to go in confident, too.
Boxing out of the red corner, wearing black with red and representing Haverhill Downtown Boxing. Please welcome Anthony Haltanovich.
It's like I said, the object of this game is to hit and not get hit back. To win a fight takes a lot of thinking on what that guy is doing wrong. A lot of fighters can't get that. It's too much to consume in their brain while they're trying to fight because they're nervous as it is. Now they're getting hit and they're saying, well, how do I stop getting hit? By that time, the round's over.
Stay straight. Relax. Arms went then. Arms went. Arms went then. Hands up, man. Come on.
Move them feet.
Move your feet. Double jabs, Ant.
Get it out of there.
There you go. Right hand now. Right hand, Ant. There you go. Right there. Let it go now. There you go. Let it go. 4 or 5 at a time, Ant. 4 or 5, Ant. Spin them out. There you go. Keep punching, Ant. There you go. Nice one.
Six, right?
You're letting him up.
Sit down.
Sit down.
What are you doing? You got a double jab right here at all? Mm-hmm. Hey, no, double jab.
Go ahead, you go.
Double jab right here. Punch hard. Come on. Can't see.
You got to punch back, Ant. Come on. Punch. Here you go. Punch, Ant. Come on, Ant. You got to punch with him.
Hit the body.
He ain't listening at all. Come on. Come on, you too. Let's go.
You're making him look like he hits like a heavyweight. Let's go.
Get them hands up, Anthony. Punch back now.
You better punch.
Come on.
Don't back up. Go forward.
Fucking horrible with these 8 counts.
You better
hey,
come over.
You want to win this fight? Do you? You're not acting like it.
You got to punch.
You got to go after this kid.
That a boy.
Come on, Ant.
Punch back. Punch. Punch, Anthony! You gotta work with him! Come on, Ant, work!
Yeah, yeah, pick some water for him. Good job. Nice fight. Diet, huh? Nice and warm out here. There you go.
Your winner by unanimous decision is in the blue corner, Rob Digitano!
Hey, good job, Anthony.
Yeah, good job, Ant. Nice try.
Ray was in the corner and they were telling me, listen, just listen, do this, do that, and I didn't do it. But I should have. I know that I have to work harder and train like a lot more and work on my skills and everything because just, I wasn't that great back then.
He was never down on himself about it. He always says, nope, next time. Work harder and try it again.
It was ready to just about be condemned, I think, but we brought it back and they're happy, you know. But, you know, they're old. Someday, like I said, when they're ready to sell it, I get first option on it. And that's what I'd like to do is make it a boxing center, you know.
He took all of his retirement money, and which is unheard of. Not many people will do that. If you really, really have your heart set on something, I think it's admirable to do that. You have to know Ray to... to understand the way he is, and that's just the way he is. He's giving. You know, he's never taking, he's always giving.
Well, dedicating ourselves to doing this, we're putting our time in. We all have full-time jobs, you know. We're down there on our own time, we're not getting paid. I think we have a good portion of Haverhill's support, a good enough portion.
Andrew to hit the top. Andrew, he wants to, you know what I mean, stick this out. He wants that for his career. That's what he wants to do, is just box, and he wants to go pro when he's old enough. Ray says, I'll get him there. He goes, I'm glad I got him young. He wants to make it into the World Olympics and fight. That's his goal. And he's got a good trainer to bring him that way. He will make a good fighter.
I shadow box like 4 or 5 rounds, then I go in the bag for like 4 rounds. I jump rope for 10 minutes straight. And then after the bag, I hit the speed bag for 3 rounds.
What do you like about Ray?
That he's nice and he's a good trainer.
Is that it?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man.
There's no self-motivation. Little sweat trickling down their forehead. Oh my God, what do I do? I'm sweating. You know, they don't want to push themselves. They get a little tired, go take a seat. Getting them to push themselves is something that I
that ain't Roachy, is
toil over that ain't on a regular guy, right? Basis.
There you go, back and forth, right?
The heavyweights, you know, we got to push ourselves a little bit more just because of the weight, you know. I mean, some of these guys are just naturally at their, at their weight for their weight class. I'm drained. I'm physically, you know, mentally, emotionally, everything. I'm drained. But, you know, I got to get back in that ring, and I want to win the gloves again, so. Just gonna keep coming, keep pushing myself.
When you get the bigger guys, they can hurt each other and not even do it intentionally. It's just that they're big kids and they smack each other. And it hurts, you know. Sometimes you have to slow it down a little bit, get in there and make sure you're on them, you know, that they ain't killing each other, you know.
When they get hit a certain way or what have you, they take it personal, like the person's out to get them and they get angry. And that's uncalled for, because we're not here to have anyone get hurt. But we also want some discipline too.
I feel like it's a moment to reflect on yourself. You find a lot of openings in your own game. You know, every time you get hit, all right, why did I just get hit? So you can always, it's all on you, you know? If you have more in the tank, like if you're in better condition, you're faster, you're smarter, you can actually think, you can move, you're more aware, you know? Like, it's almost like you're waking up and you're having a coffee, you know? So that's where you gotta get in shape. But if you're not, you take a few blows like I just did right now. You keep practicing until you get it right. How was doing?
Your arm comes flat. You want to slap.
Hey, now, stay there. Why are you moving before the hook? No. No. Hey, fuck.
Dig in like you said.
Fuck.
Get in there.
Boom. Boom. Like, look at me. Boom. Boom.
If I see somebody do that, I'm just going to...
You see that?
Again, I wasn't the meat.
You're dirty.
Hey, protect yourself at all times, eh?
See?
Three jabs.
Sorry.
Nah, shook your old guy. Oh, put on a little more interest, that about you. I hate that. Your arms are so short, kid. Right?
He took grow, huh, Ray?
Yeah, he's gonna grow.
Look at him!
Yeah!
Look at that! Look at that!
kid. You know me? Steel. Hey.
Oh, yeah, yep.
God, your name.
Oh, yeah, that's the one.
All right.
Oh, wait. Well, where's the one you were showing? You were supposed to. There it is.
Look at this.
Yeah, let's see. Opening day. No, huh? Boston, 24.
How about this with the hooker?
Yeah.
Let your wife hear that. She'll give you that.
Hey, come here. This is without a word of a lie.
Is this
I just come back from Michigan with my son. He's 59 years old. My grandson and my great-grandson. So I go to two Red Sox games in Detroit. So after we stay overnight for the next game, my boy is 11 o'clock at night. Need a hooker, Dad? Fucking horse is dead.
85.
The horse is dead.
That's it.
Forget it.
I was ready for the second round, Ray. Like, oh, you didn't even know. I was ready for my best fight.
Take that jock off with us. Get ready. We're outside.
You don't want it, man. You don't want it.
Let's go.
Come on.
They say, Ray. You never really praise us a lot after we win, and I don't, because that's their time. It's their win. Not, I've already done this, and that's what I tell parents. Enjoy what you're doing, you know, watching your child and everything, you know, because I've been through this a lot of times. But when you keep patting them on the back and tell them how good they are, then they don't want to work as hard. But after a fight, when they win, I tell them what they done wrong. So in the next fight, we're not making that same mistake, even though you won. You know, that critical mistake could get you knocked out, could get you knocked down, and you lose the fight. So when they're done, naturally, I pat them on the back, good fight. You know, enjoy this win, because we're going back to the gym for the next one now. You know? And when they win a championship, that's when it all pays off for them.
See it? You gotta come in with some conviction that you want to tear his head off, right? You can't be going
ferocious.
Ferocious, that's the word. You gotta, look, Don, put your hands up.
Ferocious, not ferocious.
No, not right there.
You're making that face.
Don't make the face.
It is.
Look, the face come here, right? Stay right there. If I'm fighting you, look at hold it a minute. Get me! Fight me!
Don't get my heart attack though, Tom.
Look at your hand. You're supposed to wrap him up here. See?
You're gonna make him bleed.
No, I ain't. Ooh, yeah. You see? You gotta get mean. Yeah, you're with these two up there now.
I think I bit my lip.
Yeah, because I almost killed you.
Who cares?
I didn't even hit him in the face.
Oh, this guy's gonna get mean. In the fight. You got that?
Yeah, okay, you got blonde and shit.
He's not yelling because to be mean or downplay someone. He's doing it for the discipline part of it. You have to have that. You have to say, you know, you're not doing this right, you're not doing that right, you're doing that right, or, you know, for safety reasons also.
It's boxing, man. People get hurt. Sorry. Say sorry after, okay? When's you gonna be 17?
August 20th.
August. Got to find out. Get him, Jack. I forget what month it is. Yeah. Jeff. Double jab. What you doing? Don't slap that hook.
He's really dedicated. He wants to learn. He wants all the professional fights, the amateur fights. He gets it on his cell phone. He's just a great kid, and he really wants to stay in the profession. And I think he would be a great fighter, and I think he is going to be. He's psyched. He's just, you know, he just really wants to, you know, he wants to be a champ. You see the passion in his eyes. And, you know, he's a very quiet kid, but very determined.
At first, I had been getting into trouble, and I had, the urge to fight. It's a great gym. Compared to any gym, we have a tight relationship. Everybody can get along. I mean, we have fights here, fights there, but to be honest, it's like family here. Anything's dangerous. I mean, basketball, you can get a concussion just by somebody bumping into you. If you listen, you're less likely to get hurt.
Full strength! Right hand! Right hand! Right hand! Right hand!
See what I got. They're gonna send him to hurt tonight, man. It's gonna be quick. Putting him down quick.
Up now, do we know?
This is number 5 coming up.
This is 5 here?
That's coming in right now.
Oh, this?
Joe Berman, thank you very much for your attendance. 56 years.
I didn't fall through it. I hit him good, but I should have put my shit through his head. And I caught him, so I just stopped it.
Benny, take that off. You can't walk around like that in the ring ever. I'm so fucking pissed at you, I told you not to do that. You're like this.
You gotta act like you're not tired. You did what we asked in the first round. You didn't get out of control. You got through it. And now, yeah, you see what it is. It ain't just because you think you're in shape. That ain't, it's nothing what you think
it is. Fucking embarrassing.
Here we go. Let's get everything off. Let's go, baby. Take
it off. Come on. Come on, baby. Warm up, man.
Come on.
There's a warm up.
No, yeah, let's go.
I want to sweat, Ray.
You don't need to. Listen, I want this over here.
Whatever you want, man.
Yeah. Please listen to me. Let's get going. It's fight time. Let's go. It's down to 100.
Yeah.
You hear me? Mm-hmm. Relax. And listen.
Hey, no. Hey, you can't punch that.
Come on.
That ruins the gloves. Come on,
hey,
will you?
Let's act like we've done this before. Come on.
But first.
Fight the fight we wanted, but he still won, and that's all that counts. Yeah.
You gotta get back to what you did last week.
Yeah, he's gotta get back. Yeah.
Oh, God. I was analyzing some things.
You were lacking big. See how he gets to it.
Got tired.
It's outside of zone. Yeah.
If you did this, boom, 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 boom.
That's true.
Hurry up, I want to get
up. To be honest with you, I felt the same way like I really did. I was like, okay, I won. Regardless, no matter what the decision was, I knew what I won in my mind, you know? So
I'll be honest with you, I didn't think they were going to give you that. Okay. You know what I'm saying?
There's no bias anymore, you know? Let the fist do the talking.
Hey, look.
Every time he touches me, I touch him twice. No homo, you know?
I know what you're saying. Try and love box.
I put some music. We're not speaking that.
No, come on. Hey, look, you're in a public place. You hear blast music.
You wait 3 or 4 years and then come back boxing as an older guy. It's tough. These young kids are hungry out there. Experience can carry you over, but it's the speed. You know, you gotta be faster. And, you know, as you get older, you get slower, you know?
Four. Jeff. 1, 2.
Get that right hand a little higher. You're dropping it down.
Four.
217.
You got, what, 15 pounds to drop?
That's not much.
In 2 months?
Rice and beans. Where's the beef, Phil?
I don't know. Look at all this. Hey, this used to be his chest.
Now, hey,
you gotta wait for me to be in shape, Phil. Hey, I haven't taken my shirt off in 5 years, you know.
I wish Papa Douglas was around.
You're the first one to
see. Tell your stories.
What's up,
you're an open joint, man. Okay? So you gotta do 201 or less. Stay still. 195.4.
195.
She used to do Taekwondo. She was on 3 national teams. She hurt her knee. And I've been around boxing for close to 40 years. So she wanted to try it. So she's been doing pretty good. She won the New England title in November, November 28th. Fought the same girl. This is the fifth time they fought.
Hey.
Your winner in this bout in the 152 Women's Open Division, competing out of the red corner, ladies and gentlemen,
sometimes they don't take us seriously because, you know, we're girls and like, they don't think we train as hard. And most of the time we train just as hard, if not harder. So it's a great workout whether they want to fight or not. It gets you in really, really good shape. And it's a great workout whether you want to fight or not. So they definitely should come in the gym.
Go have fun.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Hey, like Peyton Manning said, this might be my last rodeo. So just in case it is. It's been a real pleasure.
And I know I can do it too. So support me, and I'll support you. I'm not going down without a fight. I'm not going down without a fight. No.
I was even trying to punch down.
Yeah.
Well, you know what he's doing? He's running, but he's hanging on you.
Hey,
yeah?
The only time what he does is good is when you're tight.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm ready to keep going.
I'm proud of you.
Hey, I appreciate you guys.
Hey, you worked hard.
Anytime you want to keep, you want to keep at it, we'd love to have you.
Oh, look at him.
Let me have one pizza pie, will
you? Yeah. Go up there and have a
Maybe we should edit that to an alternate ending.
No, that was good. That was good fights.
Good to be back in there, hear the crowd going.
Yeah, man, there's nothing like it. There's nothing like it.
I think the difference is it's been 6 years and he's been fighting for 6 years, you know?
That's it. That's it.
Because out of all my fights, honestly, that was, he had the least power. He scored, you know, he threw the most punches, but he had the least power.
He came back a little tight because he hasn't fought in 5 or 6 years. But I figured he'd get the rust as the fight went on. He'd get the rust out of him. But the kid kept holding his left arm. Laying up against the ropes, grabbing him by the back of the head. He hit him in the back of the head 3 times and was never warned. They shot him a minute and 14 seconds. I proceeded to call the tournament director, Bobby Russo, and I talked to him and I said, Bobby, you know, I've got to do something about this. It's not fair to the kid that's been working out a whole year. There'll be another fight.
Can be a malfunction in the equipment or, you know, whatever, but it's happened many times. So they were good enough to not make it a messy thing, and it didn't have to be a grievance. They just agreed to fight again, so it ended really amicably. So that was good.
You're gonna beat him tonight, like you beat him the last time.
All right.
that's gonna feel better. Oh, really? Yeah. Due to a technicality, the timekeeping from there about 2 weeks ago, USA Boxing has ordered a rematch of your Central Division 201-pound Open Final, representing Haverhill Downtown Boxing, and coming to us from Haverhill, Massachusetts, please welcome Tom Roach. Representing Canal Street Boxing, he comes to us from Methuen, Massachusetts, please welcome Jesus Gomez.
In 20 years, if I didn't do this fight, I would have looked back and said, man, I wish I did.
I wish I would have fought.
And now,
that's all you fought. That's it.
That's what I did. I did it when I was 20, what, 3, 24, and I was tired.
Listen, I did this. This was my dream when I was 21, 20 years old.
18, 20, yeah.
You know?
I fought my last fight when I was 29.
That's it. You were washed up before that.
What's up, guys?
I knew.
What they told me was it. Johnny wasn't stylish enough. Did they say that to Rocky Marciano? Rocky Marciano had no style. He was just a tough son of a bitch. And that Johnny fought that style, backing the kid up the ropes, beating him to the body. But amateur boxing's not counting them punches. Now, Johnny hits him on the ropes with 4 or 5 punches. Nice, solid, straight. This way, not this way.
Well, during the fight, you have to look for punches. I mean, you know, close fist punches are... And it doesn't happen. In a lot of gyms, they call slaps, and they, you know, they slap the opponent. And that's not punching. You know, that's not a direct hit to the head or whatever. That's a slap. And a lot of judges, whether they be experienced or not, are counting that. And you see a lot of kids that really fight a really good fight lose because of that.
Slaps are not supposed to count. If he's bouncing around, it says it right in amateur boxing. Aggressiveness, style, okay? But they don't mean running around. They mean style as far as being aggressive, and that was Johnny being aggressive. Both fights. And not because he's my fighter. I thought he won 2 out of 3 rounds in both fights.
Chances of they're slim, you know, of going pro and making the real money. I mean, even if you go pro and you make a little money, I mean, what happens if you get hurt? I got a job, a house, getting married, got a dog, you know. I couldn't focus on the training as much as I would have liked to. And I think that's what happened, so, you know, to all the young kids in the gym, you know, definitely take advantage of it now because, you know, it doesn't get any easier.
It ain't always about winning all the time, and that's what I'm explaining to you in a boxing gym. I mean, if you walk off with sour grapes like he is right now, I'm going to kick him in the butt, you know, and he knows that. I'm not done with Johnny yet as far as this goes because I want him to come back, which he will, and give back to it, you know what I mean? Just don't concentrate on that loss. Concentrate on how you can help this gym be a better gym now, in which I know he will do, I'm hoping, later on down the road.
I want to make this as a career. I want to be one of the greatest, maybe a champion one day. So I have to keep on working hard. I can't quit off of one loss or something that bothers me. I just have to keep on fighting through it.
I feel like I could do it, you know, I just gotta get myself. There's so much discipline in this sport. If you really want to box, this is something you really have to dedicate yourself for. Because there's another guy out there that's giving his heart, his soul, and he's putting everything on the line to train. You know, and that's the difference right there.
Last year around this time, I wasn't really aggressive. I'd throw one punch at a time to get out, but I've been throwing more punches. I'm still looking to be a professional fighter. But if that doesn't work out, then I'm looking to be a cop, like my dad.
I make little mistakes here and there, go back to the gym, fix them. Keep training, keep fighting.
I gained some knowledge of the training, like the first time when I started my training camp here and everything. I just know like exactly what to do, what exactly I gotta do. I wasn't running at first, and running is the main thing. And some strength and conditioning here and there, but mostly a lot of cardio.
I think a lot of people can talk from the sidelines, and I think I was one of them, walked into it and thought, two minute rounds. And man, I was in for a rude awakening. There's nobody but you in there. There's nobody to blame. There's nobody to pass the ball to. This is you and your opponent. I'm here for trying to help out some of these younger guys, and maybe if we can help them focus on their education and channel that through boxing and through the sport, if we can help save a couple of lives, I think that my mistakes in the past were worth it.
No, you tell them to come in and weather the storm because it'll be the best shape of their life when they do leave here. You're not on the couch eating potato chips. That's out. Everything's out as far as your diet. Everything's good eating and everything. Even older people, I tell them, come in, work out for an hour, but take it in moderation. If you can only do 2 push-ups, start at 2 push-ups. A lot of people feel embarrassed because they're a little bit heavy. An hour a day, that's all you need in your life. Instead of being in front of the TV or being on the phone texting all the time, start working out a little bit, you know? And you could start with a half an hour. Then it builds up to 45 minutes to an hour and a half. It doesn't mean you come in the gym and work out for 2 hours right away because it's too hard. But if you start in moderation, it's the best thing. Good for your heart anyways. Keep you alive a little bit longer, you know?
I don't think it's to the point where, you know, he's gonna, you know, lock, you know, nail the door shut. But I think he gets concerned as far as, you know, are we gonna make it? And of course we are. And he's positive. We're gonna make it. That's his, you know, one of his favorite words. We're gonna make it, and I know we are.
Someday down the road, owning this building, having a community boxing center, you know, for the kids to have a place to come where they can let out all that frustration. You know, not every kid's gonna be a scientist. You know, there's gonna be kids out there that will become. We just want them to become good in society. Well, a lot of them, they can't even afford a hot dog right now, you know, their parents. I want them to take that experience, take a bad experience and make it a good one in life, you know.
I had